everybody, it's Angela back again today here to share with you some more of our wonderful entries to my Subscriber Friendship Challenge Journal. So please join me again today and have a look at what these fantastic entrants have put together. I do want to say to all the ladies who have entered already, please go back and have a look at the most wonderful comments that the other subscribers and viewers have made on your work. I've had the most amazing feedback from people telling me how wonderful you all are, how they found other people and channels on YouTube or people to follow. The response has been absolutely overwhelming, so I hope that you have all read their comments. Everybody is amazingly talented and creative. I can't reiterate that enough. This is a great chance as well for people to grow your channels. So hopefully I've steered some people towards your channels and what you're creating so that you can also grow and flourish. I am also very moved and thankful for everybody's entries. I haven't had anything that hasn't wowed me. Honestly, I really haven't. So I do want to say that right up front. I'm most grateful and, wow, as I keep telling you, very emotionally overwhelmed. I have to have a good look at all of these before I view them, otherwise I'll be crying on the video. Right, so with further ado, I'm going to head on straight away to the first entry I want to showcase for today. Now, this comes from this particular entry is a mother's entry, and I also have her daughter's entry as well, so I thought I would show them together one after the other in the same video. So this particular entry comes from Kathy Olson. Now Kathy is in Victoria, Canada. Hello Kathy. And she put together this beautiful entry, and I know Kathy says she doesn't normally work with pastels, so it really pushed her boundaries. Well, that's what it's all about. And you've done a phenomenal job, Kathy. So I've just put your entry into the draw jar over there. So I'll just put that a little bit further back. Kathy wrote me a beautiful letter, which I'm not going to share with you because it's personal. And Kathy, that's lovely. We have a lot in common. That's all I'm going to say. Right, so I'm going to keep that in here when I've finished having a look. So on the front of this beautiful entry, Kathy has layered up the most wonderful collage over here. It's got lace, it's got cheesecloth, more lace, beautiful, very mint green type of canvas. Lovely layering here, Kathy. Oh, this lace on the side here is to die for, ladies. It looks so vintagey. I just love this. This is one of the loveliest laces I've ever seen. Right up my street with those little flowers. And then she's layered up this beautiful hummingbird image here with quite a few different layers. That's absolutely gorgeous. Been tea-dyed, stained. Beautiful. She's got it onto a muted, I don't know if you can see that, but there's a muted light pink hummingbird page sort of muted in the background here, and I think she has put on some gesso, it feels like it. And then at the back, there's a lovely tag with these beautiful little seam binding. I love your seam binding, and the tiniest little bow with this. Oh, this tag is gorgeous too, stitched around it. Beautiful. I love that. Wow, Kathy, that is stunning. Just gorgeous. Really love all the layers there. Look at that. Beautiful. For someone who doesn't work with pastels, you've done a phenomenal job. Right, so now we are onto the inside. Again, a tiny little pocket over here. Look at this little envelope, if I can grip it, with a little, little note. A little note here. Look at that. Little kingfisher. No, kingfisher. Hummingbird. that fits into there, ever so sweet. And then some more beautiful layers with little bits of calico, some die cuts, cheesecloth, a tiny, tiny little hummingbird. She stitched beautifully around here into this tuck spot, and lots of gorgeousness inside here. So we have a tag on the front, which she's folded over. How clever is that? With this lovely little notebook with all these gorgeous pages. Oh, beautiful, beautiful dyeing. And look, I can even remove them if they get full. How clever are you, Kathy? I don't want to turn it up, but you can see it is removable there. Beautifully stitched. So that goes in there like that. And that tucks in behind this card there. Very clever. And then she's got a bird checklist. Isn't that adorable? That slides in there. And then behind, I'll take that out. She's taken, it looks like, oh no, it's a die cut. Beautiful peaches and pinks. And she's gessoed on there. I absolutely love that. A little bit of stamping over there. Gorgeous. Kathy, this is amazing. Very unique. So we tuck that in behind. That's lovely. And then on the back, she's put some mixed media on the back there as well. So that slides in there. And then on this envelope, she stitched around the window. Lots of different, looks like Distress Oxide here with some gesso. The way it's blended in is beautiful. Lots of mixed media going on here. And then she's put in a lovely card at the back. That's absolutely stunning. And some stamping again at the bottom. Oh, wow. Wow is all I'm going to say, and we've just started. Kathy, you are amazing. This is just gorgeous. And look, I can make some, I can write on there. And that slides beautifully in there. Just look at the page that Kathy has created. She's got lots of layers, staining, gesso, stamping. It's just really gorgeous. Now, I'm not aware that Kathy has a YouTube channel. I did look, but I didn't see anything, and I don't see anything in her note. But Kathy, you can let me know if you do. That goes in there. I want to just stick this note in there as well. And then on this side, we have a lovely tag again. And I think this is feels like baking paper. It's lovely and crackly. I do love that. She stamped a bit. She's dyed it. A tiny little tag over there. This is gorgeous. This color is beautiful. Lovely layering. Wow. It's even got date. Can make note. This is gorgeous. I love this with a string. Oh, ladies, you're so clever. So, so clever. I don't know why people watch me when I see what I'm looking at every time I show you these entries. I think, you know, those of you who don't have channels should have channels. You know, you inspire all of me. It's just amazing. Look at that. Look at the little detail there, the little flower. Beautiful friendship. Looks like a rub-on. And then layered up with some tea-stained calico. A lovely little card which is stuck on there with a, I think that's like a Tim Holtz mini clip, so that slides in there. Beautiful idea, this. I might nick that. I might use that idea. That's gorgeous. I love that. So we have that in there, and then we have it again, beautiful seam binding, and we pull that out. And we have another beautiful card over there with a little hummingbird sticking out. Tina loves hummingbirds. Tina from Hummingbird Tales. She'll love this too. Right, so that slides in there. And that fits into the other side of this beautiful pocket, which is ingenious. Really lovely. And I think this is some decoupage. Oh, no, that's fussy cutting there. And stamping. And oh, just gorgeous. I love that. Wow. And then on the back, again, some mixed media with that light background hummingbird muted page with a beautiful hummingbird over there. Just look at that. That's been layered up with lovely soft fibers. And then she's got these beautiful three envelopes with a little tag in there. She's made some beautiful cards. This is like a library card. Beautifully stained on the back. Those slide into the top envelope. And then, of course, we've got a little weenie one over here. Look at that. I love that with a string. And that fits in over there. That's absolutely stunning, Kathy. Thank you so much for doing this for me. This is absolutely adorable. And I can't believe that you say you don't work with pastels usually. That is absolutely amazing. Thank you so much. Right, so I'm going to put Kathy aside here. And I'm going to bring on her daughter. And Kathy's daughter is Val. Val, hello, Val. Thank you for entering. Val's also from Canada, I think Victoria as well. So I'm going to fold that up and put your entry into the entry jar like that. And have a look at Val's beautiful creation. Now, Val was saying in her letter to me, for this beautiful letter in this lovely envelope here, that she has, she's all new to junk journaling. So she said that her mum referred her to my videos to help her with her start in this community and to learn the various bits. And she's put together, well, you know, the people that tell me that they're new to junk journaling, I'm always so blown away, because if this is how you start, you know, that it's just amazing and so unique. Just look at that beautiful page. This is twine that she's woven onto this die cut over here, and I think this is just so amazing. Now I want to very gently just take this card out of here. So she's put on a die cut over there like that, and that's a beautiful card that she's cut out there, and that tucks in underneath the trellis over there like that. So that's gorgeous. I'll put that in at the end. So that's our front cover. Isn't that amazing? And somebody that's just started. I love the colors. This aqua color is phenomenal. I love that. Beautiful tea dyed page. You've done really well, Val. You really have. And I'm loving this tea, this seaside theme. Absolutely gorgeous. Again, she's used all my favorite shades here, so how amazing. So we have a little flip out over here with this beautiful peach pink color paper, and she's made a little tuck spot over there. Look at that, it folds out. Isn't that gorgeous? And she's got all these sea creature cards stuck in there. This pale color is adorable. I just love this. This is stunning, like a blush pink. Beautiful stitching. And she's made this lovely, it's been embossed, it's got mixed media, we've got little shells, we've got inking, stamping. Wow, you are just amazing. Val, I can't believe that you haven't long started with junk journaling. This is just unbelievable. Love the seahorse, little bits of burlap fibers here, and this lovely piece of lace. So that fits in, we'll stick him that way. Beautiful tea staining paper, or is that coffee? It's a gorgeous, really lovely. I think I've got this the wrong way around, you know. I think it's meant to be that way. Yeah, that makes sense, sorry. And then over here, we've got this beautiful little pad of paper with these lovely little details on the side with this gorgeous, delicate little piece of lace here. I love that, all the little details. Absolutely stunning, beautiful. And then over here we've got this borrowing project card, which she's cut out and stuck a little label. I love these little clips. Isn't that lovely? Look at the back of that. Beautiful. So that tucks in over there like that. And then we have this lovely pink sea creature, which I'm not sure what it's called, so we're not going to go there. Looks like some kind of a slug, but I'm not sure. Isn't that amazing? So actually, I showed you the back. So that would be the back. And then, as I said, this flip-out tuck that goes over there. How clever is that? And then on the front, oops, I think this is moved. She's got these beautiful journal cards. Look at that. Beautiful shells. Beautiful. So those go together like that, and then they tuck underneath. I'll put that on top. Look at that Great Barrier Reef. beautiful, and it says Great Barrier Reef corals. Lovely feel of this paper. It feels like straw paper or something. And then this lovely flip with beautiful lace on here. These colors together are phenomenal, and this beautiful piece of lace over there. And then of course, tiny little envelope, lovely shape, with these two little cards that fit into there like that. And then of course this fits really nicely in there like that. Absolutely amazing, Val. So talented. She stuck on a little bit of tape measure there. Edged, beautifully finished. Just gorgeous. Absolutely amazing. I can't believe, again, that you haven't long been doing this. That is beautiful. Really lovely. Right up my street with the colors. And that's ingenious. Very different, unique, beautiful. Really love that. So I'm going to stick that in there, because I like to read the notes when I'm paging through and reminiscing. I would want to know, keep that all together. Thank you so much for making this for me, Val. It's absolutely stunning. So let's put that aside. So we have that. And now I'm going to do the next lady, who, here is her entry. And it is Patricia Burns. Now, Patricia is from Waterloo in the USA. I'm not sure what IA means. I'm not sure if that's Indianapolis. I'm not sure. So don't quote me on that. But Patricia, I know you come from Waterloo in the US of A. I'm not great with my American geography. Well, not all the states and everything. Right, so we've got this beautiful entry from Patricia, as I said. Loving these lovely muted pinks and light blues. Really up my street, Patricia. Gorgeous flower over here that has lots, like a tissue flower, lots of layers. And she's put this baby soft, feels very silky, fabric on the front here, which she slow stitched at the top with some lace. And then two tags at the inside, one inside the other, with this piece of lace. Beautiful color pink, absolutely stunning. And then she's put on a die cut here onto these beautiful blues and pinks. This is lovely. I love this paper. It looks like, it feels nice and firm. It feels like it comes from a scrapbook pad, but I'm not sure, but I just love it. Really love that. And that fits in there. And that onto this beautiful old pet book page that she's inked, onto tea dyed paper. Love these pink little vine leaves. And then of course it slides into the pocket in the front there. So thank you, Patricia. That looks gorgeous. Look at that. Lovely firm paper as well. So if we turn it over like that, we have this beautiful aquamarine butterfly there. Again, Persuasion, love that book, old book page. Nice stamping over here, and lovely pink again, beautiful pink with pink stitching. It's lovely. Got a nice little pocket, the beautiful butterfly keeping it closed, and can slide something in there. I don't think there is anything in here, just making sure. Yeah, so beautiful inking, so that keeps the pocket closed, and that slides into there. She's stuck some banners down, and it says here, with brave wings she flies, the butterfly. Oh gosh, that's lovely. And she's woven in the paper across here by hand. Look at that. Interweaving, like basket weaving strips of paper. That's amazing. It's given this page some lovely strength and some beautiful velvet ribbon at the top there. That's amazing. Wow, Pat, you very, very creative lady. Now we have a fold out here. I think this is moved, but that's easily remedied. There we go, like that. She's used some acetate, made a folder over here, again with a beautiful cutout. And these beautiful tabs that I love. This color, this aqua blue green, like a sea foam colour, is stunning. And I love the butterflies. How amazing is that? Look at that. Wow. She's got some tulle with glitter in it. She's made it realistic. It looks, it's a journal card. I can write on the back. And she's made it up like a doll's dress. Isn't that amazing? Beautiful. Must be to do with the Persuasion from Jane Austen. Beautiful. Look at that woven pieces here. Beautiful quilt looking appearance with these lovely die cuts here. Lovely. And that's just a little tuck spot for the beautiful ball gown that fits in over there. Wow. Now, Patricia must be the paper pauper, so I'll move that up to you. I tried to find that on YouTube. I wasn't successful, Patricia, because you are, they have a few. So I'm not sure if that is your actual YouTube channel. I will try again when I'm putting the description details up. So that fits in there. And this is the most stunning, authentic, embossed postcard. Look at that. I love that. And it goes so nicely with this. Look at that. I love that. That's amazing. It's a birthday card. Oh my goodness, that's stunning. Thank you so much, Patricia. That's gorgeous. Goes so perfectly. Lovely washi tape as well. So that fits nicely in there, like that. And then she's got a beautiful card at the back here as well. So if I take that out, that opens up, and she's got a lovely, oh, she does. Here we go. So Patricia, let me see if I can move this over. And I'll put this in the description box for you as well. So Patricia has an Etsy store called The Paper Pauper IA. She has an Instagram account called The Paper Pauperia. And she has a, oh, you don't need that. So that's what I'll put in the description box. So thank you for that, Patricia. This is amazing. I will read that. And I will put the details for you all in the description box. So I'm not going to struggle with this now. I don't want to ruin it. And then on the back page, we have this beautiful layout. Oh, this is, it looks like a stamp. I'm not sure. But I can feel there's, it feels like there's gesso on here. It's got that feel. And she's got a lovely laugh often. And beautiful die cuts over here. I just love these colors. Absolutely stunning. Really my kind of colors. And then she's put in the most gorgeous little tag of a swan. Because, you know, they are the most dangerous creatures in the UK, I believe. there we go. So isn't that amazing? Patricia, I love that. Thank you for making that for me. It's beautifully done. Lovely colors. Just so inspirational. I love getting all this inspiration from all of you. It's just amazing. Right, so thank you. I love that. I'm going to put that aside. I then have a lovely entry from MJ Rise. I hope I've said that correctly, MJ. MJ has a YouTube channel called My Paper Journey, and she's from Coachella in CA, USA. So I think, is that California? Yeah. So MJ, I'm going to put that into the jar. Thank you. And she wrote me a beautiful card. Anne Geddes. I remember Anne Geddes well. So thank you. She's MJ's got a YouTube channel, as I said, called My Paper Journey. And that was a wonderful card, MJ. Love that. Thank you for sharing that, those your bits and pieces of your life, ladies. And MJ, that was just wonderful to read. Now, MJ put in this beautiful paper doily, and I don't see paper doilies like this here in the UK, so this is absolutely beautiful. And I love this washi tape as well. So I've just saved it lightly over there. So when you open it up like that, look at that. She's made these, well, she said she didn't, a friend of hers makes these, I think. Or did you make these, MJ? I can't remember. I did ask you. I think she said she doesn't make these, but aren't those stunning? Absolutely gorgeous. Delicately cotton. I just love them. The colours. And I've got some white ones as well. Look at that. Aren't those phenomenal? In my dreams, I wish I could crochet like that. Well, I can't do everything. Thank you, MJ. Those are lovely. So, MJ has made me this beautiful entry. I'm just going to put this flat over here so that I can show you what she's done. Now, this is the front. Isn't that beautiful? Look at those butterflies and the lovely flower. She's put on one of those lovely doilies and she's layered up a little bird. It feels like a sticker there. Beautiful layering and embossing and oh my goodness, just amazing. And this opens up, love that crown. This opens up like that. And she's used these hinges with beautiful pearls on as well. And she's cut out a fussy cut here of a flower and put on some beautiful lace. I haven't felt lace like that before. It feels a bit woolly, not woolly, but you know, a different kind of a warmer texture. And then look at the little bunch of flowers delicately put together with some embroidery twine, like a little beautifully arranged with these lovely metal corners. And then in this little glassine bag is a beautiful rose. Isn't that lovely? She's made that into a tag. Beautifully stitched. Gorgeous. Oh my goodness. Look at that there. It's a little dragonfly that she's cut out there like that on these pages. So she's made like a little notebook. Oh my goodness, it's like the secret rooms. And then a tiny little notepad with some layering with this little picture on it. And that opens, I'm running out of fingers here, opens up like that. So let's put that down. Look at that. Zoom like that. So clever. It's like a secret hiding place. I like those. You know, beautiful paper. That is just gorgeous. Very clever. Love that, MJ. That is unique. So we'll slide that in there. Oh, you ladies are so clever. Things you think of are just amazing. So that slides into that little bag like that, onto this beautiful paper over here. So if we open and close that up, so that's our front page, lots there to see. And then we open this up, and we have some beautiful journal cards, beautiful vintage images with these metal corners. Beautifully done like that. And then another one with this lovely script and crown and some flowers there, beautifully stitched together. I love that. And backed onto some other paper. That's amazing. So those go in here. And then we've got some beautiful paper here, which I think looks like it's from the same kit. And then she's layered up a lovely collage with bits of lace, bits of cheesecloth, beautiful flowers, lovely butterflies, really stunning. And on this side, we have another beautiful, this is a beautiful page, these lovely metal corners in all sorts of sizes, lovely lace design, lovely pocket here, look at the bird looking at the butterfly, and again a beautiful collage. Oh my goodness, this is beautiful edging, so unique. And then she's put in, oh that's lovely, a lovely vintage typewriter image, beautiful. Gorgeous stitching as well, MJ. You're so clever. And that fits into there. So let's put that in there. So there's a lovely pocket to hide things in. And then on the back page, we've got a lot going on here. I see something peeking out. What is that? Look at that mini ruler. Isn't that lovely? Are you saying I'm not good at measuring? That is amazing. Wow, that is gorgeous. I love that. And then we have a nice booklet here with, again, a beautiful butterfly and the antenna. I've got two little jewels on. I love that. Oh, my goodness. Beautiful rose colors. Lovely pieces of ephemera that go in here. Lovely pocket. Beautiful notepad that I can make lots of notes in. All about you guys. Let me stick that in. Lovely tea dye. Or is that coffee? Looks darker, so it might be coffee. And then, again, we've got some sewing machine. My paper journey. This tiny little booklet here. Look at that. That's so lovely. And then a tiny little tag as well with a little dragonfly. That is adorable. That is beautiful trims. Right, so that goes into the front, into this gorgeous pocket with a lovely doily. Oh my goodness, lovely pearl trim along there. That is amazing. And she's put on a lovely postcard sticker and layered it up with some fibers sticking out and beautiful flowers. Isn't that amazing? That trim is gorgeous. That is amazing, MJ. So I'm going to just put that in here for the interim and I'll sort that out when I see that. Isn't that amazing? Love these. Beautiful. Absolutely stunning. The journey, it says. Another gorgeous entry. MJ, thank you so much, my dear. That is absolutely gorgeous. Right, I've got one more entry quickly. Last but definitely not least is an entry from the lovely Sha Fisher. She's also in Australia. Sha has a YouTube channel and I will put this all in the description box again. She is Sha Fisher on YouTube. She's got an Ida Jane Designs for Instagram and Ida Jane Designs for Etsy. So if you go onto her YouTube channel, you'll find the links for the others below that on her channel. All right, so Sha has wrapped this beautifully. And that's a gorgeous image there, Sha, with that butterfly. I'll put Sha's entry into the drawer in there. And let's have a look over here. This is absolutely stunning. Oh, it's so soft. I just love this color, Sha. This is beautiful. Thank you. So, oh, wrong way. So Sha has packed this all up for me. And this fabric is gorgeous. Let's just lay it out. I just love it. And look at this little beautiful butterflies peeking out the top there. So Sha put this all together. Thank you ever so much, Sha. You have spoiled me. Absolutely didn't need to do that at all. Ladies, you don't need to be sending me extras, but I'm most grateful. I'm sure you are so sweet. Yeah, she's taken a bag and she wrapped that all around so very cleverly. Very ingenious ways for gift wrapping, I must say. And she sent me the most beautiful, I'll show you ever so quickly. Look at these beautiful fabrics, these trims. Just look at that. Isn't that amazing? I've never tried a boho journal, but I do have a course that I bought from Robin Dudley Hughes that I've had for ages. It's just that I don't get time. I've got to, oh, need to be retired. So isn't that gorgeous? So Sha, I want to thank you. I'm not going to go through all of this because time is getting short here. And I want to go and show your beautiful pages very quickly. Thank you ever so much for these gorgeous extras. Thank you. Right, so without further ado, Sha, this is Sha's page for me. I love this tree of life. It's beautiful. And I have a necklace with this kind of a thing on. I do love it. It's what I live by. So here we go. This is the butterfly, and those colors are phenomenal. And she's layered up loads here. She's got vellum printed underneath. She's got beautiful pages, old book pages, different bits, pieces of ephemera. She's got this gorgeous vintage fairy dancer, beehive things, stickers, just amazing, and these metal corners, which are stunning. And again, this beautiful vintage lace. You ladies have the most amazing lace pieces. I just love the trims. And I never find that kind of thing. So it is really well, very much appreciated. I love seeing it in journals. So here's this inside. Just look at this. And Char has put this beautiful paper at the back here. It looks like a printout. I'm not sure. It looks like a collage printout. And then she's made a booklet here, I think, or a flip up. Look at that, with this beautiful paper underneath. And more stunning lace. Oh my goodness. And then she's got this lovely envelope with this gorgeous image on this textured paper. Love that. And then, no, that is the right way. Beautiful stitching, beautiful imaging. Love the, oh, that's gorgeous, hydrangeas. And I love all this layering. And I can smell something smells absolutely divine in here. I've got to find it. That is beautiful. Smells like a spring in my house at the moment. There's a packet, there's something, a sachet of something in here that smells delectable, let me tell you. So we have this beautiful soft tulle going across the front here as well. And there's Char's lovely little hand-stamped image that she's pinned with a very pretty lilac, or looks like a mauve pin over there, created by Char. Isn't that gorgeous? And now we have another little envelope. Beautiful, that she's got a lovely cluster. Oh my goodness, these buttons are stunning. Vintage buttons with these beautiful bits of vintage fabrics and lace. Oh, lovely. And if you turn that over, ooh, we've got something in here. It's got a little note. Oh, with more little notes. Lots of beautiful, like, herbal pictures. That's amazing. And, oh, isn't that lovely? That's beautiful. I love that, with a torn edge. This is layered up. Stunning. Thank you, Char. You are a sweetie. That is amazing. So those go in there. And that tucks on the end there. Like that. I'll put that back in a minute. I think this is what smells so beautiful. What's in here? Warm wishes just for you. Oh, thank you. Kindness is courageous. Oh, it is. Seeds for your garden. Oh my goodness. Thank you, Char. This is amazing. So yes, I will put these details on there. But she, her, as I said, she's got an Etsy shop, Ida Jane Designs, and she has an Instagram, and she is YouTube, on YouTube as Char Fisher. Thank you so much, Char. This is amazing. And this smells, oh, hang on. Oh my goodness, it says fig and rose, and I tell you, it is stunning. It is just gorgeous. It's got the most wonderful smell wafting through here. Oh, I love that. Isn't that a lovely idea? So clever. Right, so we've got that. Gosh, there's like an endless supply here. Oh, we've got garden seeds envelope. Beautiful envelope, such a lovely quality. And she's got another beautiful image in there. Lovely. So that slides in there. Oh my goodness, look at that beautiful butterfly. Oh, is that a stamp? Beautiful. Lovely. Lovely. Oh my gosh, this is like a vintage letter. And look, it looks, I'm not going to say it's French or Italian, I'm not sure. I'm not fluent in either of those. And then she's got a lovely card with a stunning sari on the end of it, which is lovely. And another big postcard with a beautiful bee. Oh my goodness. I think she stuck that on there. That is lovely. She's layered that up. That is so clever. Oh my goodness. Such gorgeousness. I'm so spoilt, honestly. You ladies are unbelievable, all of you. I feel so bad. Everybody's so kind. So kind in what they send me, with their entries, just kind in the comments, kind with support. You're all just phenomenal, and I really mean that. Oh, that's just amazing. Right, and we're at the back now. Never underestimate the power of a woman with a sewing machine. Yes. That's clever. Love that, Char. That's amazing. And then we've got this beautiful vellum pocket onto this other page here with a stunning image. Isn't that lovely? Love those butterflies. Love these colors. That is amazing. Right, so that slides in there, peeking through. Wow, Char. You have gone above and beyond, as have you all. So I'm not going to struggle with these things. I don't want to damage or bend anything, so I'll put it all in properly. Thank you so much, so very much. So just to remind you what we have here, we've got Char Fisher, beautiful entries. We have Val, we have her daughter, Kathy. We have this from Patricia Burns, and we have this one over here from MJ. Isn't that amazing? So I need to move all these up a little bit. Isn't that stunning? Loads, 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 loads. Tell you, my journal is going to need a 15-inch spine at this rate. Ladies, I want to thank you all again. All these entries are phenomenal. You have spoiled me beyond belief, just in what you've produced, what you, all the lovely comments you give me whenever I put up a video, just all the lovely happy mails, just everything. And all my subscribers and all my supporters of these people, I just want to thank you all, because every comment, even if it's about the lovely entries, I value, because these people are going to all this trouble, all this effort, and I appreciate that all of you are supporting them, because that is wonderful. Isn't this community just amazing? I thank my lucky socks every single day. I look forward to seeing you in another episode of our entries. So thank you all for joining me again today, and as I said, if you would like to press the like button, leave a comment for any of these ladies or myself, please go right ahead and do so. Thank you ever so much, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye now.